Hi guys, welcome to Saute at Sight.
Like and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for latest updates and recipes.
Hi guys, welcome to Saute at Sight.
So today we are going to cook one of my favorite meat based dish, that's dal gosht. Well, dal gosht is originated from Hyderabad, but we also make it in Mumbai, and most of the Parsis and the Muslims in Mumbai have made their own version of it. And when I was small, basically I used to not like eating much of meat, as it knows it really well. I was a typical vegetarian, and I used to avoid eating any kind of meat. Only the thing I used to eat was chicken and maybe some kind of fish, but not any other kind of meat.
Well, when we started dating, that time she told me, like, you know, I'm gonna make you start eating all the vegetables, and apparently I was the one who changed her and made her eat all the possible meat, that is.
But till today I can't eat some kinds, of course, but I've been eating most of them when I started dating Aston. And I remember when I was small, my mom made me taste this dal gosht, which was a traditional family recipe. I loved the blend of lentils with the meat, and it was very subtle. So I really enjoyed that dish, and as I grew up, I was really fond of it. I've not made this dish since long, and Aston has never tasted it. So I was just thinking, you know, like, how come I have not prepared this dish? And I made him taste it, which he absolutely loved, right?
Yes.
So I want to share the recipe with you all guys. So let's get started.
So let's start preparing the dal gosht. Well, basically I will take a cooker and heat it. Ensure that there is no water while adding the oil, otherwise it might, you know, crackle. Now the cooker is heated, I'll be adding in some oil. Add some generous amount of oil because you need to fry the onions well. As you can see, I have taken 500 grams of mutton, and these are small pieces, and I've marinated it with some salt and turmeric for about 2 to 3 hours. Once the oil is heated, I'll be adding 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds. You can see it's crackling, and once it's done, I'll be adding some chopped onion. I've taken a big onion and chopped it. Fry the onions well until they are really brown in color. To this I will add 1 bay leaf. While the onions are frying, I'll coarsely pound some ginger, garlic and some whole spices. I have taken about 2 inches of cinnamon, 4 cloves and 10 pepper. And in this, I've taken about 5 garlic cloves and 1 inch ginger. And now I'll coarsely pound this. Keep stirring the onions so it doesn't burn. This is what the onion should look like, slightly browned. I've already coarsely pounded the garlic, ginger and the whole spices. This is what it looks like. And now I'll be adding this to the onions. The coarsely pounded spices and ginger and garlic gives you a very authentic dal gosht taste. Fry the ginger and garlic until the raw smell is not gone away. Now while the ginger and garlic is frying, I'll be adding in some slit chilies. I've taken 4 chilies. Also, I'll be adding in some fresh curry leaves. Now I'll stir this well. Now once the raw smell is gone away, I'll be adding in some chopped tomatoes. I've taken 2 small tomatoes and finely chopped them. I'll add this to the cooker. 1.5 teaspoon garam masala, 1 teaspoon coriander powder, 1/2 teaspoon turmeric powder. Because I've already added previously in the marination, so I don't want to add too much of turmeric. And 1/2 teaspoon chili powder. You can alter the spices as per your requirement if you don't like too much of spices. Now I'll mix this well. I'll add a little salt so that the tomatoes cook easily. I need the tomatoes to be mushy before I add in the mutton and the dal. So while this is frying, let me tell you guys, I have taken 1 cup of moong and tuvar dal. But you can always be creative with this. You can use any kind of dal with dal gosht. They usually use masoor or, you know, chana dal. But since I didn't have any of those, I'm using the mixture of moong and tuvar. Always ensure to properly fry the masala. And to know whether the masala is done, it should leave the oil from the sides. That's how you know your masala is done. As you can see, the masala has left the sides and the tomatoes also are mushy. Now I proceed to add in my dal and my mutton. And I mix this really well. So the masalas get mixed with the dal and the mutton. Now to this I'll be adding some water. You can take 3 cups of water. Now I'll be adding some salt as per taste. One tip, don't add too much salt. In case you know, you feel after it's cooked, if there is not much salt, you can add it later. But to alter the salt, it's very difficult. Now I'll cover it with a lid and let it cook on a medium low flame. I'll give it about 7 to 8 whistles and then my dal gosh is done. So as you can see, my dal gosh is now ready. I'll be giving it some nice tadka of fried onions and ginger. So now my dal gosh is now ready and I hope you'll enjoy watching this video, guys. Please do like and subscribe to our channel. You can also follow us on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter by the name of Saute at Site. And you can also log into our website www.curioushomechefs.com for latest updates and recipes. So I'll see you next time, guys.